Welcome back. Fox 8 News in the morning. This week, UH hospitals announced that they are taking part in a new COVID vaccine trial. Dr. Amy Edwards with University Hospitals Rainbow Babies and Children's are joining us now with an update on that trial and other coronavirus news this morning. Doctor, always good to see you, always good to talk to you. So let's just get right to it. First of all, currently working on a vaccine at UH. It's been going on for just, it's relatively new right now, right? What can you tell us about it?
Well, it's from the company Pfizer. Mm-hmm. It's a phase 2-3 combined 2-3 trial. We're already enrolling. They're seeing volunteers this week who are starting the process of getting informed consent and getting their first shots. It's a 2-dose. You either get 2 doses of placebo or 2 doses of vaccine. You won't know, and your doctor won't know, and they'll follow you over time and see what happens.
Now, who can take part? Are you still looking for volunteers?
Oh, we're absolutely looking for volunteers. We're looking for anybody who is relatively healthy, who hasn't had COVID, and has not been on any COVID medication. To contact our vaccine trials division and sign up.
Now, how close are we to getting a vaccine? We keep hearing about Russia, who they claim they have one already, and then over in England, Oxford University, they're working on one. How close are we here in the States?
So the one in China and the one in Russia, there's actually been two that have been released to the general public, but neither of them went through the final phase trials. Mm-hmm. So we actually don't know a lot about them. But the ones that are going through, we have, I think there are 5 or 6 vaccines in phase 3 trials. That's the final phase. And so, you know, we could be looking at a vaccine sometime early 2021,
okay,
mid-2021, depending on if it works or not.
And if that happens, we'll be still dealing with this virus, you know, a good ways after that, huh?
It really depends. If it's a really effective vaccine, mm-hmm, like think about the measles vaccine that's 98% effective, mm-hmm, we could wipe mm-hmm this out in a couple months of vaccinating. If it's not very effective, if it's more like the flu vaccine, then we could struggle with this for a while.
Yeah. All right, talk about the CDC. They have new testing guidelines. Can you explain those briefly to us?
I can explain them. I can't explain why they are advising them. Most of us disagree with them,
wow,
to be very honest.
Okay.
So what the CDC is saying is that if you've been exposed to COVID and you're asymptomatic, that you no longer need to be tested. And most of us in infection control and in public health wildly disagree with that, because we know that the asymptomatic people are a huge portion of the spreaders, of the people who are getting other people sick. And so we absolutely need to know who these people are. My only guess is that, you know, once again, we are running short of testing kits, and perhaps the CDC is doing is making that recommendation in an effort to preserve testing kits, but most of us disagree with them.
Last question, here in Cauca County, we're down to level 2. We're doing something right, it seems.
I think we're seeing the effects of our mask mandate. I really do. I way back when Governor DeWine mandated masks, I predicted that by the end of August or early September, we would be reaping the rewards. But what I want people to see is that just because we're at a level 2 doesn't mean we're out of the woods. If we go back to what we were doing before, we'll go back to the results we had before. So we need to keep going so that we can have a safe fall and winter and so that our kids can stay in school.
Cannot let our guards down.
Absolutely not.
Dr. Amy Edwards from University Hospitals, thank you very much for your time this morning. Appreciate it.
You're welcome. Have a good day.
All right.